feet look better than your feet.
I know, but my feet are pretty cold.
Reception, number 85. Rookie wide receiver.
Brett Favre is looking, and he's giving someone a motion here with his mouth. And this is the side that the blitz is coming to. He moved his back to the other side, and they brought the blitz from the other side.
That's Freeman. And Freeman gets to the 49er 45, stopped by Marquez Pope.
Yeah, if Brett Favre has a go-to guy that is a wide receiver, it's this guy Antonio Freeman. Antonio Freeman is kind of one step below being the top one. You know, you know what I mean? And he's going to take that step. And the only thing he is, he's a little inconsistent in that he'll make some great catches and then he'll drop some real easy ones.
2 minutes left to play in the first half. 19-13. 2 minutes to go. In San Francisco, Favre looks left, throws right. And the pass is caught by Freeman.
You know, the thing that a quarterback has to do is to be able to get up and to see and to read, but you have your stuff you do before the ball is snapped. Listen to Brett Favre here.
I don't know what that means.
I have no idea. It had to be. I mean, the 27-4, the 27-4 can be the audible.
Yep. Derby. Travis Derby bounces all the way down inside the 30 to the 27. Stopped by Zach Brunson. That might be the longest run of his career in regular season.
I think somewhere he had a 16-yarder, didn't he? But he hasn't had a lot of long ones. And again, you can see that if he ever gets that vision thing, because you know that if he gets outside and gets there, he can break away with his speed, but sometimes he does everything too quickly and he has to have a little patience.
Arb drops the throw, flag on the play. Illegal motion by the Packers, apparently.
All star, prior to the snap, number 86, offense, still first down.
I think he disagrees.
He's saying that he was pulled off or something. 86 is Antonio Freeman here. That was right. He did move.
Yep.
Marquez Pope could move. You see, Marquez Pope came up like he was going to jam him, and Antonio Freeman started to move. I think what Mike Holmgren was saying, that he was drawn off, but if you're back as a defensive back, you can do what Marquez Pope did.
Freeman to the 20.
So Marquez Pope was going to mess with Antonio Freeman, and they came right back and they messed with Marquez Pope.
Don't forget, coming up on the Visa Halftime Report, JB, Terry, Howie, and Chris will have all the scores and highlights from around the league. And our Fox Sports ticker will have up to the second stats. That's all coming up on the Visa Halftime Report.
Watch this. Here's Antonio Freeman. You see, Pope just jumps a little to the outside, which is really good for Antonio Freeman because he's running an inside pattern, which is a slant. And then Brett Favre is going to hit him when he gets inside of Marquez Pope and before he gets to the safety, number 46, Tim McDonald.
Going to be second and two or thereabout.
Yeah, that's what Freeman's laughing about. He said, he got me. He got me the play before that because he made me move. But then I got him on the slant on the next play.
Antonio Freeman is one of those who will be a free agent at the end of the year. And he's going to be in demand.
Yeah, well, he's already has over 100 yards of reception today.
Raymond Harris is the deep back. They need 2 yards. Favre has a man wide open. That's Freeman again, and Freeman gets the first down at the 11.
See, that's the thing that you can't do. You can't blitz and then lay off on the corner, because he's just going to, now what? We just, here he is, and you see how far the corner is off. You can't do that on a blitz, because you have to play man-to-man coverage, but you got to get up and you have to press it. Because if you blitz, Brett Favre's going to see it and get rid of the ball. And if you make it that easy on him, where you're not pressing the outside receivers, Brett Favre will eat you up on that all day.
Green Bay just took their last timeout. They have a first down up to 12 of San Francisco. They lead 19-13 with 33 seconds to go. Don't forget, coming up on the halftime report, the Visa halftime report, J.B. Terry, Howie, and Chris will have scores and highlights from around the league. And Fox Sports ticker will have up to the second stats, all coming up on the Visa halftime report. And they'll be with us next week, John.
Yeah, they'll be down there in Dallas with us, and it's always nice to see them. Always nice to have the guys on the road, huh?
Yep. Far pump fake. Throws, intercepted in the end zone by Lee Woodall.
Well, Brett Favre looked up at that one. He doesn't want to see that.
No.
If he's had a problem this year, it's been those interceptions in the last four or five games. But he tried to look off, but he didn't look off Woodall. You see, he's trying to work on Marquez Pope out here. Now, he has Pope okay, but he doesn't see Woodall coming in here, and he throws it right. See, now, Freeman has Pope beaten.
Yeah.
So that's what he sees. He's watching out there. He gets inside. And maybe had he hit Freeman quickly, he could have done that. But Lee Woodall backed up there, and it got into the next area or the next zone.
And that is a big, big interception for the 49ers, 19-13.
Yeah, because the Packers may not score a touchdown down there, but they definitely had a field goal.
Yep. Steve Young is going to run out the half. They'll head to the locker room, but that was a big interception by Woodall.
And I think that really helps the 49ers,
yes,
taking
sir.
A little momentum into this locker room right now.
Keep that in your memory bank. That could really be a factor. The Packers and 49ers head back with the locker room. That's the end of the first half of the score. The Packers 19, the 49ers 13. Fox NFL Sunday will continue with J.B. Terry, Howie, and Chris in the Visa Halftime Report after these messages and a word from your local Fox station.
I always remember Chuck Noll telling me, you get inside that 20-yard line, we want to at least come away with an attempted field goal, so you really have to protect the football. But Brett is aggressive, and with that gun, I don't blame him, but you got to be very careful.
All right, let's fire up the scoreboard and show you how Minnesota got knocked from the ranks of the unbeaten. Tampa Bay's ground game impressive, over 246 yards on the ground today, combined rushing for the Bucs. Bucs stay undefeated at home. Minnesota knocked from the ranks of the unbeaten.
I can't believe you took that highlight when you've been sitting here all day long screaming for the Redskins, who get their first victory, 21-14 over the Rams.
Didn't want to make it appear like I was a homer.
But you
Falcons
are one.
Stay right on the heels of the NFC West leading San Francisco 49ers.
Jake the Snake Plumber, Frank Sanders, touchdown passes. There you have it. They get the victory on the road, go to 4-4.
Panthers now no longer winless as they upend the Saints.
Broncos only undefeated team, 33-26 in a great game up in Cincinnati, Chris.
Chris Collinsworth says, I am now a believer in Doug Flutie, who guides the Bills over the Dolphins.
Three touchdown passes. Way to go, Doug. Jaguars, look at this. 45-19. The Ravens in trouble. Mark Gibraltar in trouble. Hey, your Patriots. There's another team you like to kiss up to. They take care of the Colts.
Because Henry Ellis there. What happened to your Steelers?
Well, my Steelers took a day off. But you know what? That's okay. Every now and then you can take a day off.
All right.
Maybe.
Well, Terry took a little bit of a break, because when we come back, for those of you who will be coming back, we'll be taking you through highlights, and he'll be doing it in rapid fire succession. Others will be going to local news.
All right.
Hey, mind if I play?
Brett, let's go.
Hey, dude, there's Brett Favre. Come on.
Oh, hey, mind if we play?
Mind if I play?
To the left. Pizza! Who orders the pizza?
Say, man, mind if I play?
Sorry, Dion, game's full.
Let's go!
Who do you think you are? It's fucking stuff.
Even you got in.
You're never gonna get my love.
witness how these people survived. Some of the most shocking moments ever caught on tape.
Oh, my God.
An all-new special, Thursday at 9, 8 Central on Fox. 113 escapees from the devil are throwing one wicked party. But one man...
Where'd you come from? Where are you going back to?
...is about to crash it. Peter Horton stars...
Speak of the devil.
...in Grimstone, an all-new episode, Friday at 8, 7 Central.
All right, back here with the Blonde Bomber. I'm the Brown Bomber, James Brown. Let's get you caught up on the scores. Hey, Brad Johnson itching to get back in the Vikings lineup.
Well, that's good for him, but here's a guy itching to get in the end zone. Ward done. Mike Alstott, great lead block. Ward done, 10-yard touchdown run. Tampa Bay up by 7. Now, Cunningham deep, 44-yarder to Jay Reed. Great throw, great catch. They do it better than anybody, 14-all. Now, Cunningham back. 1-yard touchdown pass to Jake Reed. It's 24-17 to Minnesota. And then Mike Alstott, this 6-yard run. There he is, into the end zone, over 240 yards rushing by Tampa Bay. They take care of previously undefeated Vikings.
Hey, here's a highlight. Neil O'Donnell to Marco Battaglia.
There you have a touchdown. It's 26-24 Denver. Hey, let's go for two. Smart football. Why not? You're losing. There's the ball up in the air. Carl Pickens fights for it. There you have a tie ball game, but it doesn't last long, folks. Not with this guy. Terrell Davis bounces around to the left. Goes in for the touchdown. Denver remains undefeated.
Smart quarterback coming up, Doug Flutie. He goes to Reimersburg. He's smart.
This is right. The second time for the day, this 16-yard touchdown pass down the middle, 14 off. Then Avery leaps over from 1 yard out. It's 21-14 Miami. Flutie back again. Guns are down the sideline. Hey, nice job. 48 yards, Eric Moles. It's 24-21 Miami, but with 13 seconds left. Marino up in the air. Oh, Jim McDuffie catches it. Falls down at the 4-yard line. Not enough. Buffalo wins it, 30-24.
Enthusiastically, TB.
Okay, I can't. I'm out of breath. Trent Green rolls right. Steven Davis catches it. He runs in, 12-yard touchdown. It was 14-7. Giants going to win their first game. The Redskins do. But Eric Davis, he takes his 56-yard interception off of Billy Joe Tolliver. He goes all the way. Carolina wins their first game, 31-17. Please excuse me, Washington Redskins fans. It just took a lot of air out of me, and I couldn't get it all out.
You just didn't want to give Washington credit.
I don't want to do it over.
Second half, Green Bay, San Francisco.
A lifetime of dreams. Super Bowl 33 on Fox.
The coordinators and defensive coordinators and guys become hooked. But the thing that they've had is they've had great quarterback for all those years. First of all, Joe Montana, then when he was finished, Steve Young.
McWaters returning the kick. Comes out of the pack. Chased by Longwell, stepped out of bounds in front of the Packer bench, but a good return by the 49ers number one draft choice.
You know, we talked about that just at halftime when Lee Woodall got that interception in the end zone. You could just feel the momentum change.
Yep.
And you could feel the 49ers go into the locker room with the momentum, and then boom, here they come out and they just get a good wedge, a good lead block. McWaters gets up in there, he takes it up into the wedge, then when he breaks that, he takes it out to the sideline to get up to the sideline before he's knocked out of bounds. A 45-yard return. That's a pretty good start.
Gives them great field position. And Young is trying to take advantage of it as he gets it out to Greg Clark. The tight end, Koontz, made the stop. And let's look at first half statistics.
Well, you can see that, you know, that running is not going to be a big part of what either team does. You know, but they have to get enough of it just to get the passing, because that's what it's going to be about. The 49ers had more first downs. But, of course, the Packers, you know, had that one turnover and then that 7 points off the turnover. And, of course, they got the safety by that bad snap that went through Reggie Rose's hand.
Those two things are the difference. 19-13. The pass caught by Owens. He's cut down quickly.
You know, the other thing is because they had the safety, they had 2 points. And then if you add the 1 point where they missed the extra point, or had the extra point block, then that's 3 points. So that's like giving the Green Bay Packers a field goal.
Third and about 4.5. 19-13, Packers leading. San Francisco at the Green Bay 39-yard line.
These are the situations where Steve Young is really tough.
Yep. Well, that great mobility he has. He's going to use some of it right now, chased by Reggie White. The ball deflected by Keith McKenzie.
Yeah, what a year Reggie White is having. You know, it's his last year. We talked to him the other day, and he said, no matter what happens, this is going to be my last year. You know, he can still make all the moves and do all the things and run like he used to. I mean, those were some great athletic moves. Yeah. I mean, he started, he jumps over a guy, he chases a guy. Steve Young didn't gain anything on him. And, you know, Reggie White has been one of the best for a long time in this league.
Not just a player. Reggie Roby's punt sails to the end zone, way back into the end zone and out. And so Green Bay will start to their own 20. They lead by 6. We're in the third quarter.
All right, Captain, we're going to have a coin toss now. This is a team, we'll call it in the air.
Green Bay over San Francisco, Pat Summerall, John Madden. Green Bay's ball at their own 20. Far. Jeremy, a yard. Passing by zone, John. What does this mean?
Yeah, when we get through with all this stuff, we'll shout. You see what it is? It just shows how many deep passes they threw. Brett Favre in the first half threw 3 passes over 15 yards. One was a touchdown here to Freeman. This was a touchdown to Brooks. Everything else that he threw was under 15 yards. And I think some of that deep stuff is there for him.
Jeremy. And Travis Derby gets a first down. Did you look at Brett Favre then? See what he did?
Yeah. I watched him in practice the other day, and you know, he just starts that in practice, but he was doing basketball shots. I mean, he would hand off, then do a basketball shot, you know, like a jump shot. Yeah. Then he did a behind-the-head dunk.
Well, that's what he did then.
I know it. He was practicing that Friday, adding, you know, instead of football moves, he was adding basketball moves.
Well, they're on strike. Maybe he wants to do some of that. Blitz coming. Favre gets it out of there, incomplete. Intended for Freeman.
Talking about them being on strike, the Milwaukee Bucks' new head coach was in the up here before the game. He was in the box, George Karl. George Karl and his wife, along with Rick Majerus,
the coach
from Utah. Yeah. They came and ate a bunch of our brats. I had a case of brats here before the game. Guy gave me a case of brats. I get a year's supply, a case a month, and in a case is 12 dozen. So we had out there in front 144 brats. And you know what? When the game started, we only had 30 left.
I was going to say, we've taken care of a bunch of them.
But I think it was Majerus and Carl.
Well, Majerus, yeah.
I think they ate like 100 of them.
Here's Favre, and this time has time. Screen pass to Jervy. And he's up to about the 34.
This is what I was doing before the game.
Everyone, all of everyone gets brought.
You look so warm.
Well, see, you got stuff like that. You put them up there, and then you put them in, and you feed them.
There's a director, Sandy Grossman.
Brats for everyone.
Is that in your cookbook, your new book?
Yeah. Threw some Proud in there.
Yeah.
See, brats for everyone. I was making brats.
I had my share.
Yeah, but that's why Lambeau Field is so good. I mean, where else can you cook brats right outside and then throw some Proud in and have brats for everyone? That was a pregame meal.
Throwing deep for Brooks. And the pass is intercepted and no flag. Zach Bronson with the interception gets back to the Green Bay 35. Adam Timmerman made the stop.
Ooh, and that was close. That was close on Marquez Pope, not on Bronson. Bronson, that was a 2-deep. Bronson was just waiting back there. Marquez Pope, again, a physical guy. Watch Pope, he's right here, and watch how he can be physical, and he's going to stay underneath, and you see Bronson is going to come over the top right there. I think it was R.W. McQuarters
yep.
is who it was. If there was any interference, it was on McQuarters. That ball was just overthrown by Brett Favre right to Zach
Bronson.
Yeah,
he thought there should have been an interference call.
Yeah, on R.W. McQuarters, yep. though, not on Bronson.
That's Garrison Hurst, the ball carrier, to the Green Bay 30.
This is what happens to a quarterback after he throws an incompletion or an interception, I mean, then he becomes a defender. Chris and then Dolman. When he's a defender, those guys are going to go after him. Now, Dolman was an offender. I mean, he becomes an offender, and he's going to go offend the quarterback.
Hurst to the secondary to the 10. Hurst is going to score, and the 49ers have a chance to take the lead.
Well, they quiet this crowd, didn't they?
Yeah, they
just kept working it. They got the interception. They got the turnover instead of giving it. Then once you get one of those things, you have to do something with it.
49er down.
Here you just see a good fake. Now watch Steve Young. He does that same type of fake, but it was a cutback hole right there on the left side. He started to the right. And then the Packers over-pursued, and they left that hole back there on the left side.
I think it's Chris Dahlman who's the injured 49er. And can ill afford to lose him. 19 apiece.
Francesco LaFabula has just created the little black dress that will change everything.
He was going to the right, but he finds the hole on the left, and that's where he broke through.
And the extra point is blown again. The holder throws incomplete. Ty Detmer was the holder. Throwing it, Chad Fan, incomplete. And that's two extra points the 49ers have botched.
Yeah, and you think of the punt snap that went through Reggie Roby's hand.
Yep.
You get this snap here was a little high, but he does get the ball down.
And it slipped
out. But when he gets it down, it just slipped out of his hand.
Yep.
Nothing wrong with the snap. That was Ty Detmer.
How did you happen to be at Ruby's today?
I was 19. 10:21 left, third quarter. One safety. The ball slipped through the punter's hands. Two missed extra points. One was a low kick. One was just dropped by Ty Detmer. He tried to put the ball down.
All those special teams miscues.
Certainly were. Roel Preston, and right now for an NFL update, let's return to James Brown in Los Angeles.
Pat and John, Denver averted a big scare today in Cincinnati, thanks in major part to Terrell Davis, 149 yards, two touchdowns on a day, well on his pace to breaking Eric Dickerson's 2,105 yards. Wow, Denver getting by Cincinnati barely. Pat, John.
And we're back at Lambeau Field, starting to get colder. Especially on the Packers side of the field. Here's Favre back to throw it. Gets the pass complete down to Chimura, who shakes one tackler and picks up an extra five.
Yeah, and that was the first pass that he threw to his tight end, Mark Chimura. Yeah, you thought that he was going to be a bigger part of that today, and you just see him right down here. He just starts out, and he just hooks right on the hash mark. So Brett Favre knows where he's going to be. He's just going to be right there in the hash mark. He just goes back and just, boom, just hits the tight end right there.
Got a first down up to the 48-yard line.
Russ Verber, the second-year left tackle, doing a pretty good job over there today on Chris Dolman.
Two tight ends set up. Raymond Harris was the setback. Favre fires, and the pass is intercepted again by the 49ers, Tim McDonald. Not again by McDonald, but again by the 49ers.
Yeah, Brett Favre is getting in a funk now. He had that one to Lee Woodall just before the halftime. Then he come out after half, and he throws to Zach Bronson an interception, and then he comes right back and gives one to Tim McDonald. Or Tim McDonald and Zach Bronson and Lee Woodall got in position to do that. Again, it's a pressure defense. They come with a blitz, and you see Tim McDonald was just free back there. And what he was doing is he was reading Brett Favre. And he had a guy on his right and a guy on his left. Now see Brett Favre look, and when he stepped there, Tim McDonald jumped just as Brett Favre started to deliver.
Three out of his last six passes have been intercepted. This is Hurst. Well, the 49ers gets about 3 yards down to the 46.
Well, and I think that's the point of not having a running game. And it's not only that it puts the pressure on the quarterback, but it puts the pressure on the whole passing game, on the line to block, and on the receivers to get open. And this momentum started to change towards the 49ers just before the half on Lee Woodall's interception.
That's exactly right. Here's Jerry Rice in motion on second down. Steve Young looks upfield and throws complete to Edwards, Mark Edwards. Hit by Bernardo Harris, didn't get a first down, picked up about three.
You know, that's the thing, this 49er West Coast offense has always been where the fullback has been a part of it.
Yep.
You know, I mean, going back to the, you know, Roger Craig and Tom Rathman, and the fullback has had to be a receiver. I mean, it's not a big tight end offense, but it's a big wide receiver. Now this year, more three wide receivers, but the fullback is also a part as a receiver.
Third and four, here's Young. Gets it outside to Owens. He gets out of bounds, but I think he got the first down. He's close to it.
But Terrell Owens is a big, strong guy, and if he knows where that first down marker is, that's the advantage to have him. They have the advantage of being able to do a jump ball, but they also have an advantage after they catch the ball. After they catch the ball, of being able to get the first down. You see right here, he catches it a little short, but he's strong enough just to run right through a tackle to a point.
Shoved the tackler out of the way. Terry Kirby is the deep back. Young fakes to him. He's chased and just does get rid of it. And Kirby batted it backwards. Good play by Kirby, too, not to catch it. Because he would have lost yardage.
Steve Young just had to throw that one away because you're going to see the blitz is coming. There's Leroy Butler right there. You see him? He's coming free. Now, Steve Young told us this, he said, I always have to know where Butler is. That time, he saw him before he came, and watch his head right here. He sees Leroy Butler right there, says, I'm going to get the heck out of here. He tries to do a reverse twirl and throw at the same time. And that's why Kirby knocked that down, because all that stuff is happening to Steve Young.
To Garrison Hurst, bounces down to about the 32. Terry Kirby, this is not Hurst. Kirby came back in the best shape they say he's ever been in, or best they've ever seen him.
See that they're taking Chris Dahlman out now with a strained left knee. His return usually is questionable when they take him out on a cart.
Third and five. Young across the middle. That's Kirby. Stopped finally by Pat Terrell.
You know, and the 49ers waived Terry Kirby in the offseason, and then he was out there as a free agent. Levy really didn't do the job, so they brought him back in this situation here to be the third down back, the pass receiver. See, Steve Young was looking downfield for his wide receiver, couldn't find anything, and came off to Terry Kirby, who has always been a good receiving back.
Steve Gordon is the center in place of Dahlman. That's Garrison Hurst for a couple. 19-19 score, 6:05 left, and Mike Holmgren looking on and wondering.
He looks to me like he's looking on in shock.
Yeah.
I think they started off, and sometimes that'll happen to you in this game. When you start off well, and it looks like everything is easy. Remember the first pass, Antonio Freeman, touchdown, turnover, safety, all those things. Sometimes your team, after things being easy early, have a little letdown.
Young outside. That's J.J. Stokes, another big, strong receiver who is down to about the two.
And that's the thing about these big receivers that we talked about. You know that they can get a jump ball here, but when you get a corner playing that far off, why even run a pattern? Just stop, get the ball out there, and let him just run right over the smaller defender. Now, if he could have stayed in bounds, which I would try right there, try and hit and stay in bounds, that could have been a touchdown.
Third and goal at the two, and this is when Young becomes so dangerous with his ability to run. Looking for a quarterback draw, which just didn't take.
Reggie White says he has the ball. He's saying it was a fumble. The Packers looked like they were in the 49er huddle on that one.
Yes, they did.
Usually that thing is supposed to open wide, and the quarterback walked in there. That was like Steve Young again ran into a wall. But watch Reggie White. They're going to pinch right here. The minute they see that, there's nothing in the middle. And I'll tell you, they just converge on number eight. Ooh, they knocked him every way but loose. And maybe they knocked him loose.
Richie back to attempt the field goal with Detmer holding. Richie's kick is good this time. Finally, they manufactured some points off their kicking game. 20 yards out. 49ers get the lead.
I wouldn't call Charlie's parents.
Connections between them are, well, they go way back. Mariucci's from about 100 miles from here. He used to go to all the Packer games while he was growing up. Casey Bradford. And the kick comes out, the return comes out to about the 26. That dinosaur is active, isn't he? Don't miss coming up tonight.
Twas right before Christmas.
Eye in the Sky camera proud to provide you with these live shots. They're just 1,000 feet up over Lambeau Field. Their view is almost as good as ours, I think. Maybe better.
Yeah, because they can move their view.
Travis Derby. Flag on the play.
Remember a couple years ago, Mike Holmgren was telling us about Travis Jervey, where they had that thing against a seven-man sled where you'd run plays into the sled and the backs run in and then they bounce outside the sled. And he said Travis Jervey was a four-hole play, ran right into the sled as we're blocking the sled. In all my years of coaching.
52, offense, still first down.
Frank Winters.
Yep, here's old Frank Winters there. You know, and he does a lot of that. I mean, he's a real tricky veteran. And you know, and tricky veterans do things like that. I mean, they get a hold and then they try and fall down and drag the guy down with them. Didn't work on Bryant Young.
Timeout, 49ers.
Frankie Winters got his hand outside. Usually they get that hold inside, and then when they fall down, they just bring them right down with them. You know, when we're talking to Brett Favre, he's talking about his interceptions. He says that he doesn't lose confidence. Sometimes he looks like he loses confidence, or he looks like he's a little in a daze. He said, but what it is, he doesn't lose confidence. He just can't believe it's happening.
Next week on Fox NFL Sunday, we'll be in Dallas to watch Danny Cannell lead the Giants into Texas Stadium to battle Troy Aikman and the Cowboys. Plus other regional action. Coverage begins at noon Eastern, 9 a.m. Pacific, right here on Fox. Check your local listings. And of course, JB and Howie and Chris. Terry will all be there.
Yep, you can't beat that, huh? No. Now, there are certain things that makes a game feel big. We talk about him, you know, being here at Lambeau Field, the Packers having a blimp and having the pregame show.
Favre incomplete. Intended for William Henderson out of the backfield.
You know, whatever it was, the Packers got off to such a good start, and then they don't have it now. And I think part of it is this 49er defense. They've gotten very aggressive. Watch Tim McDonald here. I mean, he's a guy that likes to play close to the line of scrimmage, but always has been a real hitting safety. And anything that moves anywhere in the secondary, at the line of scrimmage, in the backfield, Tim McDonald is going to zero in on the hit.
Favre drops. To Chimura. Picked up about five. Ken Norton took him down.
Yeah, we talk about Leroy Butler, Pat, and how good a player he is as a on the Green Bay Packers, and I think that Tim McDonald is that same guy for the 49ers.
Just going to say, earlier, you remember, well, here's some more aggression by McDonald.
Yeah, I mean, he's just all over the place. I mean, he plays zone, and he keeps everything in front of him, and then that stuff that he keeps in front of him, he goes and hits.
Remember, you were talking about early in the game how aggressive the Packers were. Now it's the 49ers.
And I think that's exactly it. I think the Packer defense was aggressive on the 49ers, and now the 49er defense is going after the Packers.
Favre incomplete in the direction of Antonio Freeman.
That's a good point you made, because not only have they gone aggressive, but then by being that aggressive, they've taken all the rhythm. They've taken all the rhythm out of that Green Bay offense.
McWaters back deep. And Sean Landetta to punt. Slipped off the inside of his foot. Waters will take it at the 28. Cuts it back outside and steps out of bounds at the 40. It's never been on cable, premium channels, or any other network, but tonight it's on Fox. They've been with us, those dinosaurs, most of the day.
Oh, yeah, I mean, that's another good thing to have with you.
Yeah.
Props, Lambeau Field, Packers, 49ers, dinosaurs.
Hurst. Finally knocked out of bounds by Sharper.
You see the guy that was patting him on the back there is Bob McKittrick, the offensive line coach of the 49ers right there. One of the best. And he's the guy that is not only the line coach, but he's responsible for the running game. And he loves to do this. You know, pull his guard. You see big old Gogan there?
Yep.
He makes that block right at the point of attack. And Hurst gets right in behind big old Gogan and breaks off him. That's the kind of offensive line that Bob McKittrick coaches, to make those kinds of moves and have that kind of coordination.
And get that kind of gain, 20 yards by Hurst. And here's Hurst again. Not much this time. Knocked out of bounds at the Packers 39 by Brian Williams.
You know, somewhere you'd think with these wide receivers that the 49ers have that they'd take a shot long. Their longest completion so far has been 12 yards. And you'd think somewhere with Jerry Rice or J.J. Stokes or Terrell Owens that they would take a shot deep, because if there's anything that the Packers have been vulnerable for a number of areas, but the one area is Tyrone Williams, their right corner. You know, people have been throwing deep over on that left side.
Second and 9. Pass complete to J.J. Stokes, who drags the Packer defender for a first down. Tyrone Williams.
Yeah, and that's who, you know, they've been working on, and they've been working on him deep, and maybe that's why he's off so much, because you see Tyrone Williams is so far off, he's not going to give you the deep one now. But in not giving you the deep one, he's giving you everything in front, and he's giving you first down, so you can methodically work the ball down the field.
Which is what they've done since they took over the momentum and took over the aggression. Young's 18 out of 26. Pump fake going deep. Incomplete. J.J. Stokes had it for a moment and lost it.
And that was a deep one that I was just talking about, and I think by going in front of him, they thought that they could suck him up to get him up, but he's still off. You see, he's not only off, but he's backing off even more. And then they tried to run that slant and go on Tyree, and he was really beat.
Yeah.
I mean, J.J. Stokes had him.
Catch the ball, Steve Young says.
Yeah, because that's the one he's waiting for. You know, they don't take a lot of shots as 49er offense, and when they do, they want 6 points.
Terry Kirby gets the carry, and he's tripped up. Maybe he got a yard. Reggie White.
Hey, Reggie White, you know, we've always known him as a pass rusher, and one of the things that he's really never gotten the credit for, it. Maybe he has, but he's a good run defender. I mean, he's a solid guy, and he always has been. And just watch how he just controls and just plays that trap, and no one blocked him. See, when the guy doesn't block you, then you look inside. You go from the guy over you to the inside running lane looking for the trap, and there was no trapper there.
Kirby in the backfield with lone setback behind Young. Young gets rid of it, incomplete. And the 49ers, I don't know if they're close enough for a field goal try or not.
Well, you know, after what Jason Elam did last week in Denver, I think that anything under 60 yards is close enough for a field goal try.
Wade Ritchie has a very strong, strong leg.
Hey, Steve Young has thrown a couple of balls in there on this drive that should have been caught. I think the one to J.J. Stokes more than that last one.
This attempt is 47 yards out. Detmer Holden. High enough. No good. And they'll bring it back to the line of scrimmage. Bring it back to the point it was kicked. I'm sorry.
And they bring it back to the spot of the kick, yeah, which will be 7 yards behind the line of scrimmage. These balls coming. Whomp.
Certainly far enough, but hit the left upright and bounced out.
One thing after you kick, you never want to hear another sound. You want the thump of your foot on the ball, and then you don't want another thump.
No, but you want to cheer.
I know, but when you get that thump on iron, that's usually a bad thing, although you can get an iron thump that'll bounce inside, too.
You can. I've done that.
Reggie White, an amazing guy, isn't he? Yep. Oh, what a dominant player he has been over the years.
Three wide receivers for Green Bay. Far gets to Jervey, and Jervey gets about 3 yards. Lost World, don't forget, coming up tonight at 7, 6 Central here on Fox. Several times we've almost lost the Fox box to those dinosaurs taking big bites out of it. But that's all coming up tonight. Lost World.
I think that dinosaur took a big bite out of Mike Holmgren's play chart there in the second half. He hasn't come up with a lot of good ones.
Second and 7. Far to throw it. Pass caught by Brooks.
But he put the mustard on that one.
Did he ever?
If there's such a thing as a fastball pitcher in football, that fastball pitcher is Brett Favre. Watch Robert Brooks. He's going to come under control there against the zone. You get right in between Woodall and Tim McDonald under control, and Brett Favre saw that and just zipped it right between them.
That's Marquez Pope.
And he has a bad back. He's had a bad back since training camp, and it's really never gotten better. And he said the only thing that has gotten better is the area of the pain has gotten shorter.
Got a cramp now, I think. And they are painful also.
Well, you know, anytime you get anything wrong with your back, you start to get a lot of other things wrong. I mean, you'll get a knee, you'll get an ankle, you get hamstring, you get cramps, and I think it all comes back to originating in the back. He says when he first got the back, they told him they weren't sure, but it was either going to be bone, muscle, or what's the other thing? There's three things.
Bone, muscle, or cartilage, maybe?
No.
No?
Or what else could it be?
Got to be cartilage. But that's not what it was. That's not what he said. You're right. Bone, muscle, or?
Nerve. That's what it was. And, and that's it. I mean, you get something in the back, and it's either going to be, the bone, the backbone, it's going to be the muscle around it, or it's going to be the nerves going up and down.
That's the end of the third quarter with the score of the 49ers 22, the Packers 19. Fox NFL Sunday will continue after word from your local Fox station.
The Lost World, with new scenes added tonight on Fox.
My prayer is to linger with you at the end of the day in a dream that's divine.
Hello?
Steve Young?
Yeah.
Here's our new cellular offer, Mr. Young. Outside of long distance, weekday minutes are divided into
listen to this guy.
Non-quasi-peak, semi-peak, non-semi-peak, pseudo-peak.
Cellular phone offers are not always clear, but ever since Sprint PCS built the only all-digital nationwide network, everything is clear, including the offer.
Hello?
Sprint PCS is now just a dime anytime, with free long distance.
That's good.
Mr. Young? Steve. As I said, weekday minutes are... Say, what's that smell? Anyway,
now it's just a dime anytime with free long distance.
Behind every Ford Oval, there's a story to be told. The Ford Taurus story dates all the way back to Henry Ford himself.
I will build a motor car for the great multitude, so low in price that anyone making a good salary will be able to afford one.
Now, the 99 Taurus was a ways off back then, but with a 5-star safety rating and a sticker price $1,000 lower than it was last year, I think Mr. Ford would consider Taurus a job well done. Ford Taurus, built to last. See your Northern California Ford store today.
Are babies being sold to Bay Area couples? Monday at 10.
22-19, the 49ers lead. That's Travis Jurdy breaking a tackle and getting a Packer first down across the 30. That's his most impressive run. Not the longest, but most impressive.
Yeah, because, you know, we talk about Travis Jurdy and having the speed, not a lot of vision. But he is also a very strong guy.
Yep.
In fact, in one of those muscle books, you know, they had some kind of contest, and they had him as the number one muscle guy or the best body in the NFL, for whatever that's worth. You know, there's some things you have in your head sometimes you shouldn't know, and you wonder how you know those things.
That's Jurdy again who gets the carry down to about the 25, 24-yard line. Norton on the stop.
You know, there was there for a while where Mike Holmgren wouldn't play Travis Jurdy because he fumbled so much.
Yeah. Now he doesn't fumble.
Yeah, I mean, I think he drove him crazy, too. Travis Jervy's he's a surfer. And, you know, that kind of mentality doesn't go with Mike Holmgren. When we were here for the preseason game, remember, he had his hair bleached.
Yeah.
And he got a bad bleach dye because they don't know how to bleach guys' hair here in Green Bay.
Is going to take off himself down to just inside the 22. It's going to be third.
I'll say this, that this 49er defense has really been playing crisp. When we talk about how they were aggressive, but they're crisp and they're sharp, and they're just swarming everything. Chris Dolman was the first guy there, and he just stuck with it, and he got far. That knocks out the rhythm. See, right now there's no rhythm. There was almost no neck or head either on Brett
Favre. Almost no football.
I know, but that throws it out of rhythm, and now anything can happen.
Third and six. Favre to throw. Incomplete. And no flag. Freeman was the intended receiver, and Favre thought there should have been interference again.
This is Darnell Walker there. He's on Bradford there, see, and he starts to get a jump, and they thought that he tackled him before the ball got there. I think that he tackled him before the ball got there.
Too.
I think that Darnell Walker dodged a bullet right there.
Ryan Longwell back to attempt this field goal, and it's going to be good. 45 yards out. That ties it up at 22 with 13:14 left.
Constructed out of cotton that was purposely mistreated to make it hard. We've rolled it between slabs of pig iron to make it rough and unyielding to the touch. We dyed it dark as anything made out of dirt can be dyed. All with utter disregard for your dainty, petal-soft skin. Levi's Hard Jeans. You're welcome.
Arriving at last, from Saturn, the world's first three-door coupe. Why didn't anyone think of this before?
Fox. NFL Sunday is brought to you by Saturn, makers of the world's first three-door coupe. Why didn't anyone think of this before? By Budweiser. Now's the perfect time to enjoy a fresh, cold, Beechwood-aged Budweiser. By Burger King. If you ask us, it just tastes better. And by First Union, your guide to the financial world.
Sellout crowd at Lambeau Field, 22-22 the score. And no one has departed.
I'm sure they're not going to depart here either.
Nope.
This is a great combination. You know, when you have a game here, it's like half pro game and a half college game. Had the Wisconsin marching band at halftime.
McWaters returns the short kickoff to the 32-yard line. Again, coming next, never seen before on television, The Lost World, Steven Spielberg's. And we just lost it.
Yeah, you know, as you look at Steve Young there, he was saying that you know, the more experience you get, the more the game slows down. You know, like when you don't have any experience and you don't really know how to play this game of quarterback, everything is so fast, everything looks like a blur. So then as you get experience, everything slows down for you, and that's the way the game is for him now.
And a handoff is straight ahead to Edwards, who gets up to the 35. But when the game starts to slow down, as he was talking about, you'd like to still be healthy enough to be able to continue to play it.
That's what he says. You have a window. You know, there's a part when you're young, you don't know how to play the game, and then you get where you know how to play the game. Before you get too old or too hurt to do it, there's a window there where you can do it well, and he's in that window right now.
He sure is. Here comes the blitz. The fumble, the ball's loose. And the 49ers, I believe, got it back.
And the guy that blitzed the
Butler.
Roy Butler.
Yep.
Steve Young says, I got to know where he is on every play. We have to account for him. And I'll tell you, he came from Steve Young's side. Watch, here's Roy Butler up here. You can see him. Steve Young has to know where he is, but Steve Young is looking the other way. So that really becomes his backside. He's a left-hander. He sees, but when he turns to his right, watch him. He looks out here right now. He sees Butler, but they don't do anything about it in pass protection. No one blocks Roy Butler. And Steve Young is looking to his right, and that ball is knocked out of there.
Young drops again. Screen pass coming. It's pretty well set to Kirby, and he is taken down on a fine play.
I think they just had to get Steve Young off in the sideline, because I think that shot by Leroy Butler really rattled him.
That was Rod Smith who made that excellent play on the screen pass. Just picked up last week.
Yeah, and Fritz Sherman. I talked to Fritz Sherman the other day. I saw him, and he was using him in his six defensive back package, and said he was waived by Carolina, just picked up, and Fritz got him ready to play in this game.
Reggie Roby back deep to punt. Royal Preston handles it and scoots up the sideline to about the 38 before he goes out of bounds, and that's where the Packers will take it over. With 11:13 left to play, if we can save the scoreboard.
The new Saturn Coupe has better pickup than a Maserati. After a Little League game, anyway. The world's first three-door coupe. From Saturn. Why didn't anyone think of this before?
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue. Think to myself, what a wonderful world.
Fortunately, there's Nasonex nasal spray, an effective nasal allergy prescription medicine taken once a day that relieves sneezing, itchy runny nose, and congestion, indoors and out. Now that's wonderful. Nasonex, what good days are like every day. The most common side effects were headache, viral infection, sore throat, nosebleeds, and coughing.
Now that the bunny has the new advanced battery, it's a whole new ballgame. You have to be prepared for just about anything. Ain't that right, boys?
New Energizer Advanced Formula. No battery lasts longer.
The suspense.
Mulder, I think we're on to something huge.
Must be killing you. The X-Files. The new season begins next Sunday on Fox.
Back at Lambeau Field, which has gotten kind of cold. But after all, it's November, and we're in Green Bay, and it's supposed to be cold.
Yeah, and if it weren't cold, it wouldn't be Green Bay, and it wouldn't be football.
And football, indeed. 22-22.
This is great hitting weather.
Raymond Harris is the deep back as Favre drops halftime. Off to the races is Antonio Freeman. Touchdown.
I was just thinking they have to get back to Antonio Freeman. Antonio Freeman had caught six passes for 131 yards, and it was all in the first half.
And that one adds 62 yards to it.
The first pass of the game was a touchdown to Antonio Freeman. They've forgotten about Antonio Freeman this half, and then they come back. Here he is right here. And you just see, he's just starting out on a go. He makes a little out move, and then he just runs right by Marquez Pope.
Yep. Who had no help. The extra point by Longwell is good. And it's 29-22. The Packers have the lead again. Touchdown pass to Antonio Freeman.
Okay, it's my big debut. Here we go. Wise. Okay, I'm ready when you are.
Good.
Wise.
Did he forget his line or what? Is this the regular one or is he the understudy? Is this? Yeah, thank you. Hey, you gotta wait for me. Let's hold it, not you. He goes, then I... Wait a second, not you! Hold it! Wise! What? I can't work in this environment! Cut! Cut!
May I help you?
If I wanted a Whopper, no pickles, that wouldn't be a problem. But would we get to hear you sing?
No, sir. You get to hear us sing.
Hold a pickle, hold a less special order, don't go.
May I help you?
If I want my value meal with rings
instead of fries,
is that a problem?
Value meal with rings or fries, it still costs the same great price. You don't have to ask us twice to have it your way.
When you have it your way, it just tastes better.
Arriving at last, from Saturn, the world's first three-door coupe. Why didn't anyone think of this before?
Be there to say goodbye when Brandon Walsh leaves Beverly Hills.
I have no regrets.
Neither do I.
90210, an all-new episode, Fox Wednesday.
11:04 left, 29-22 Green Bay. Brett Favre is now the Packers' all-time passing yardage leader. He just passed Bart Starr, who's in that ring of honor. Well, he should be around Lambeau Field's second deck. This is R.W. McWhorter. Flag on the play as McWhorter is taken down.
You know, it's funny how defense can change momentum. We talk about how the 49ers got it back with Lee Woodall's interception, and then how the Packers got it back with Leroy Butler's hit on Steve Young. It just changed the whole momentum back to the Packers, and then Brett Favre hits Freeman.
Illegal blocking him back. Join the return. Number 30 of the receiving team.
Tyrone Davis is the injured Packer. And they can't be losing him, can they?
You know, Antonio Freeman has 193 yards so far. That's his career high. And they kind of look the same. It was the same down the left sideline. That first one was a zone where Merton Hanks didn't get over. Brett Favre looked right and hit him there. This one in the fourth quarter is just an up. See, he goes, gives a little out move, then runs right by Marquez Pope. And again, Merton Hanks taking a terrible angle. You know, on those two catches, Pat, Antonio Freeman had 115 yards after the catch. You watch this, and I don't think he's going to threaten Michael Jordan. Do you?
No, I don't think so.
He can't even get it up to the top of the bar. Nice guy, good receiver, good catch, not good jump.
Tyrone Davis limping off to the sideline.
In fact, Antonio Freeman didn't even try the Lambeau leap. That was in lieu of the leap.
He was so disappointed at missing the dunk.
There's Merton Hanks. He's taken bad angles twice today on both of those touchdowns. The first one, I think, was really him, Antonio Freeman, because he was a deep guy in that zone. And then on that angle there was Marquez Pope, but the free safety had to be over there to help him. And again, I think he took a bad angle on both those touchdowns.
First down at about the 7-yard line. And Steve Young back to throw it, gets it to Jerry Rice. Rice out to the 19 for a first down, stopped by Bernardo Harris. Today's game being brought to you by, produced by, I should say, Bob Stinner, and directed by Sandy Grossman. The associate director, Mike Roig. Broadcast associates are Fran Morrison and Charles McDonald. The technical producer, Bob Muller. And I'll get to the rest of it in just a moment. First down, San Francisco. Here's Steve Young. And there is Steve Young down by Bonnie Holiday.
I'll tell you, that was great coverage out here, Pat, by Rod Smith. We talked about Rod Smith. He's a right corner, and that's the area that he's trying to go to. Watch Steve Young here. You see, he's trying to come out to this side. You see, in fact, he pumped and he threw it, and then Bonnie Holiday got there. Now, how did Bonnie Holiday get there? Watch Rod Smith right here. See, this is where he wants to throw. He comes up, he jams, he jumps inside. He gets between Steve Young and the receiver, and that's how Bonnie Holiday got that sack.
Second and 15, two tight ends set up for San Francisco. And Steve Young back to throw. Sprints to his left, throws back across the field. Knocked down by Craig Newsome.
Well, that's one of the first times that they've tried to throw the ball on Craig Newsome, and it was a different way. Here we see the right side. Steve Young, while this is going on, is rolling to the left side. You see, and they tried to lull Newsome to sleep by making him think he was going across, and he just stayed with Terrell Owens perfectly. Watch how he just gets his hand in there right there and knocks it off.
Good recovery by Newsome.
Because he was watching Steve Young, who was rolling the other way.
Three wide receivers this time. Third and about 14 yards necessary. Young lost the ball. And the Packers have it. Santana Dotson came up with the ball. They put the heat on Steve Young. He lost control of the ball.
And that's that same edge. That heat came from that same edge that Frick Sherman was talking about. That's the edge that you have to work, because that's where they've gotten their sacks today. If Steve Young is going to run, he's going to run to that side, but it comes right here. You see Keith McKenzie, he just starts out, he just runs right by Jamie Brown, sticks his left hand in there, and knocks the ball out. Watch Keith McKenzie, he's going to come here. Now watch, he sticks his hand, up. The ball was out before Keith McKenzie's hand got there.
He just dropped it. Santana Dotson.
He felt McKenzie coming off of that edge.
Yep. Travis Jerby. Jerby, touchdown.
He'll do something crazy.
There he goes. He may not come back, knowing him.
He was enjoying that way too much. Yeah. But I tell you, I still say it all started with that hit by Leroy Butler on Steve Young.
Yep.
It changed the whole momentum
sure
this second half.
Changed the way Steve Young was looking upfield even. Extra point by Longwell is good. That's the first Travis Jervey touchdown in the NFL. He is proud.
We know they're out there. Individuals who ask more from a truck than 99% of the world. To us, they are the one percenters. With their demanding standards in mind, we introduce the all-new GMC Sierra. With our most powerful Vortec V8s ever.
I thought that was it. I mean, yep. I thought that's when they took over that defensive aggressive, that toughness, all yep. those types of things, when they took it over again was on that hit.
Line drive kickoff. Going to be handled by one of the up men. I think that's Chad Fan. Irv Smith, beg your pardon. Look at this fumble again.
Yeah, well, here's how it all started. Keith McKenzie's coming from his left side. Steve Young sees him. And when he sees him, he puts his hand down. And when he puts his hand down, the ball hits his knee and just pops out. And Santana Dotson's there. Then they get in the I formation. Watch the block here by Henderson, the fullback. That is a good block. And then Travis Jervey knows, I've never had an NFL touchdown, but I'm going to get one right now.
And I never leaped into the stands, but I'm going to do that right now.
Well, William Henderson gave him a pretty good lead to get a soft corner over there.
Young out of the pocket, taken down by McKenzie. Continuing with those who are responsible for bringing you this game, along with John and me, technical producers Bob Mueller, technical director Joe Benda, audio supervisor Fred Aldous, studio produced by Scott Ackerson, as they go back to work in a hurry. Vaughn Booker made the stop.
Vaughn Booker is the guy that comes in for Reggie White, and Reggie says that he feels so good about Vaughn Booker because he knows when he comes in and he feels comfortable that he can play as well as Reggie's playing now. And on that sack there, he looked like it.
Yeah.
Vaughn Booker, they got in a trade from Kansas City.
Most in his career, 8 times.
Well, that was a Green Bay Packer objective today, was to put Steve Young on his back, and they started going after him from the get-go.
Here's Steve Young, and here's Reggie White. And Santana Dotson, but Reggie was first.
Hey, Steve Young is getting beaten up here. It's Reggie White, because Vaughn Booker can come in, they can rest Reggie White, and there's that club move.
Yep.
That's that move that Derek Deese was saying, I don't want to be clubbed, I have to be patient. Maybe he hadn't been clubbed all the time, but he got clubbed on that last play by Reggie White.
And the 49ers. Back in front formation is Reggie Roby.
Most right tackles in this league will be clubbed by Reggie White.
Royal Preston back to about the 48. Like to welcome to those of you who've just joined us. Joined us at Lambeau Field. Pat Summerall with John Madden. The 49ers led it 22-19, and now it's 36-22 Green Bay, as they have turned everything around. Jervey. And for those of you tuning in to see the premiere of The Lost World, it will immediately follow our coverage of the NFL on Fox. For those of you out west, Lost World will air at 7 p.m. Pacific. Just sort of bring you up to date, Brett Favre has had 3 passes intercepted. His first, however, was about an 80-yard touchdown completion to Antonio Freeman. And right now, he's got things back on track.
He also just broke Bart Starr's all-time passing record today.
That's Raymond Harris, who maybe gets a yard. Maybe not.
And one thing about Brett Favre, he's such a competitor, you know, that he does have those three interceptions, but he just stays with it.
This Garrison Hurst scoring for the 49ers. And then in the fourth quarter, as Green Bay retook command, Freeman from Favre. That's his second touchdown catch of the day.
And that was the first time that they'd thrown to Antonio Freeman in the second half.
Favre drops the throw. 49ers were blitzing, incomplete. Antonio Freeman the target. And the last Packer touchdown by Travis Jurdy, his first in the NFL.
Again, Merton Hanks is having a tough day. I mean, he's taken some bad angles, missed a tackle there. Travis Jurdy gets his first touchdown in the NFL, like you say, and then he goes and does a Lambeau leap. Stayed in there a little longer than most.
Yep, he did. I thought we might not get him back. Landetta's punt bounces out of bounds at about the 12. Don't forget, we'll be here, of course, the list is over. And coming up next, The Lost World. Never seen before on television. I'm not sure I want to go there.
I tell you, talking about a lost world and going there, how about, in Heroes, we talk about Steve Young and Brett Favre and these guys. How about John Glenn?
How about that?
Seeing John Glenn and knowing that he's up there now, and Walter Cronkite talking about it.
At the age of 77, isn't that amazing?
And the Major League is a pretty good place to live.
Young throws to Rice, to Hurst, beg your pardon. Best seat in the house today and tonight is inside the Bud Bun airship. The aerial ambassador of the King of Beers. High up over Lambeau Field. Pass incomplete in the direction of Jerry Rice.
Yeah, you were talking about all the, you know, where Steve Young, you know, played with Mike Holmgren when he was the coordinator. Mariucci was an assistant to Holmgren. He's from this area. And the other thing is Mike Holmgren was a coach at BYU. He was Steve Young's quarterback coach at BYU. And in the first game that he was a quarterback coach and Steve Young was a starter, Steve Young threw six interceptions against Georgia. And Mike Holmgren told him, he said, I think you're going to get benched and I'm going to get fired.
Young is chased out of the pocket and chased. And the pass drops to the grass harmlessly.
Steve Young is doing more and more of that this year, and I think that's saving him. What the rule in the National Football League is if you're outside the tight end box, outside where the normal tight end would line up, you can legally throw the ball away. If you're inside that tight end in the back, you can't throw it away.
There's Reggie Roby. Notice he wears a watch.
That has to be a kicking thing. That has to be something that kickers do.
I was asking before the game, he said, way back when he started this, it started in the NFL, he had a deal with a watch company. Flag on the play. The deal has long since expired, but he just wears it kind of as a good luck charm.
Well, it didn't bring him much good luck today.
No, it didn't.
First time he went back to punt, the ball went right through his hands, and the Packers got a safety.
Holding number 31 of the kicking team is declined. First down.
This had to be a big game for Steve Mariucci. He's from this area, Iron Mountain in Michigan, which is the upper peninsula, within 100 miles from here, and he has his whole family there. In fact, there's their people right up there.
But I think the family might be gone.
Yeah, but the thing is that's not his people, though. I mean, that's his people from Iron Mountain, but that people, you know, afford to pack.
Yeah.
So his people are from Iron Mountain, but they're for him. That's a different group, Iron Mountain.
There is Raymond Harris. Nothing to it.
You know, you think of the difference today, how the Packers started out, and they had complete command and looked like they were going to run away with the game, and then the 49ers came back and looked like they had control and they were going to win it.
They got ahead.
Then the Packers took control, and kind of been like three different games, hasn't it?
It really has. Chris Dahlman is on the crutches. Second and seven. Less than 5 minutes left to play now. As Raymond Harris goes straight ahead and picks up about three.
I'll tell you, when those guys run inside these Green Bay backs, I mean, they've found some stuff in there, but they've really taken a lot of big hits, too.
Yep.
I mean, that's a thing with Bryant Young in there, Junior Bryant playing very well. They've run into a lot of walls, but the one thing about Mike Holmgren and his play calling, at the end of the game, he's going to be pretty well balanced.
Yep.
I mean, he's going to win it with the pass. He's going to win it with Brett Favre's arm.
And he knows
throwing
that.
Throwing to Antonio Freeman. But he also is going to keep enough running just so you know that he will run.
Where was that moon last night?
Ooh. That was the one we wanted
scary.
Last night. Yeah, we talked about... John Glenn and those guys, they're out there somewhere, aren't they?
But I mean,
they're not going to the moon, but maybe they're like here, right around here, hanging
could
out
be.
Here.
Could be saying hello from
like
there.
That. I mean, they may be there.
Hey, you just drew a pumpkin.
Well, yeah, but I don't know where they were, but I mean, that's my guess, my calculated guess, if that's where they would be in relationship to where we are and where the moon is.
My guess is they'd be a little higher than that.
Above the moon?
No. Above where your mark was.
No.
Can
you believe a cow jumped over the moon?
I never bought that one. Harris squirms down. So the Packers will have to punt. Didn't get enough for first down, but got across midfield.
Yeah, they're just trying to take some time off the clock and make the 49ers use some timeouts. In fact, they made the 49ers right there by running that ball use their last timeout.
Don't forget, coming up next, The Lost World, Jurassic Park, Steven Spielberg's classic.
You know, one thing about the fans here in Green Bay is they really enjoy their football, and they're not one that said, okay, we won this game, it's over, and start to leave, beat the trap. They just stay here and enjoy the moment. I mean, they come here, they're going to make a memory. They're making a memory here. They're enjoying everything that's going on right now.
McWaters takes it out of bounds at about the 29th. Here's Green Bay's next five at Pittsburgh. The Steelers lost today at the Giants. The Giants lost today at Minnesota. Minnesota lost today.
And I think that's the big one for them. I mean, that's why this game was so big today, is Minnesota had a two-game lead. So if they lost and Minnesota won, they could be three games down. But now by Minnesota losing, and if they win, then they're one game and they get to play Minnesota again. So they're going to feel pretty good about themselves after this game if they win.
Steve Young back to throw it. And does throw it to Jerry Rice. Out of bounds. San Francisco.
I think San Francisco has a little easier road here.
Well, it looked like it, but you never know the way things are going.
Well, I mean, they have to play well, but I mean, the only team there that, you know, seems to be playing well is Atlanta.
Yep.
Atlanta wins today, but Carolina won, but they've only won one game all year. They play them twice, the Giants. I mean, there's not a lot of strength there that, to me, should worry the 49ers.
That's Owens in motion, and Young back to throw. And he gets it to Owens, and he's cut down immediately. Rod Smith He didn't play like that at Carolina. We saw him twice.
Well, I'll tell you, and Keith McKenzie, I don't know that he's played like he's playing today either, because he's really putting on a rush from this right side. We talked about this edge and this side and the things that had to be done here. Keith McKenzie is really doing it.
On second down, Young fires to Owens, got the first down, and Owens fighting is knocked backwards to the 40. They'll give him his progress. Stopped by Craig Newsom.
I think somewhere the 49ers are going to have to throw one deep.
On third down, they got to have time if they're going to do that. There's the one you wanted deep. That's to Terrell Owens. And he gets down to the 10. A big, strong guy he is. Steve Young said, hurry, but there's a flag on the play.
And Reggie White's walking off the field here, and he's pointing back to that flag that it's going to be against the 49ers. Reggie's already off on the sideline.
You know, when I was walking by, I was down on the field before the game, and on the way back coming through the stands, I mean, everybody knows everybody.
Holding 63, offense, still third down.
Some guy said to me, is your partner, John Madden, all he talks about is eating. Does he do anything else? I
said, yeah, I watch football. I watch Reggie White. Yeah. I can't enjoy it. I mean, if you can't come here and enjoy a brat, I mean,
that's right.
I got a case of brats here. Cooked 144 brats out.
I got my share.
Oh, that's part, I mean, you know, brats and football and Packers and Lambeau Field, yeah, and Vince Lombardi, it kind of all goes together.
Young pass is incomplete, intended for Jerry Rice. Reggie White coming back on the field.
Yeah, and this is the situation that Reggie White loves, yep, too. Yeah, I mean, when you get a team and then this is going to be a fourth down, last ditch effort, and you know it's going to be a pass. Watch Reggie on this one.
Put some heat on. 36-22, Green Bay over San Francisco.
Look at Reggie's day already. He has 3 sacks and 6 tackles, and he just came in. He's going after 4. I'll guarantee you, Reggie White came in to get sack number 4 right here.
He won't get it.
Yeah, he can still get it.
Steve Young had the ball slip out of his hands, I think, or hit somebody's helmet the way he's going.
Well, he had one slipped out of his hand earlier when he fumbled that ball, and then the Packers got it and scored. See, he doesn't have anything there.
Yeah,
he
hit a helmet.
He's just trying to get rid of it. And we talk about Reggie White, who's been on him all day. The other guy's been on him all day was that guy that was on him right there, Leroy Butler.
Yep.
He's at a bad angle, but he has played a heck of a game.
You'd think the way he played today that he might consider playing some more, but he said yesterday to us when we talked with him, no more, this is it.
Yeah, Reggie White, yeah, that's it. Leroy Butler's gonna play some more.
Yeah.
You see him go over there and give a hug to Fritz Schirmer.
There's Derby. Bangs away for about 4, 5, maybe more.
You know, you wonder what this does to the 49ers, because we talked about them having a monkey on their back before the game, and they really do. I mean, Steve Young has never beaten the Green Bay Packers. The Green Bay Packers have knocked the 49ers out of the playoffs the last 3 years. They've beaten them, now it'll be 5 in a row.
Yep.
And so at some point you have to say the Packers have the 49ers.